Hi, it's Paul from howtonetwork.com and 101labs.net. You may have heard that Cisco has announced an update to the current CCNA. Now, a while ago, they changed the format where they're going to do the testing. Instead of a 3-yearly update, it's a yearly smaller update. And then every 3 years, there's a major update. So I've actually written a blog post giving you all the information you need to know. I'll put it in the description here so you can click on it. So basically, the yearly updates are going to be incremental. Around 10% of the exam content is going to change. And what they'll be doing is adding the current exam title. So Cisco CCNA will be 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, for example. And then there'll be a major update every 3 years. Now, with every 3 years, there'll be a new exam number released. So I've gone through the syllabus and decided to pull apart what's been tweaked, what's been removed, and what's been added. Now, there are new topics, 3 new topics you need to learn. I wouldn't worry because you can learn all of these in less than a day just by doing some of your own research. Now, the topics are generative AI and how it impacts networking, Cloud Management, and basic machine learning concepts for networking. Now, if you want to compare these side by side, if you just Google Cisco CCNA exam topics, if you Google Cisco CCNA, you can actually find this page, but you'll find the current exam, which is CCNA version 1.0, they're calling it now, which is a 200301. This number will stay the same, but the exam is changed into CCNA version 1.1. So if you go to here, you'll see the new syllabus, and this is the current syllabus online. But what you can do is download it in PDF format for the 1.0. And when you go to the new exam version, you can download the 1.1. And I just Googled PDF compare, and then you can just click on select file, and I'll find the file that I want to compare, which is the two CCNAs. So on the left, I want the 1.0, the current one as of today. And then down here is the add button. And what I'll do is add, you can add a URL as well if you want to paste the URL in from Cisco, the 1.1. I'll click on open. There's a compare button you can click on. It will only show you one of the syllabuses, but if you click on view inline, side by side, now you can see, and obviously there's going to be up here changes, for example, version 1.0, and it's version 1.1. So what you can do is just scroll down and see the highlighted changes. I'll go through these anyway. So if you scroll down, first thing you'll see is Cisco DNA Center seems to have disappeared, and WLC. I'll go into this more in a moment, but I wanted to show you the facility that you can use to see for yourself, just in case I missed anything. So these are the new topics. The actual topics from the new syllabus are 2.8, which is your cloud management. So on my blog post, if you come, you'll see a italicized text for anything that's been added or changed. And 6.4 has actually replaced a syllabus item, and it's now called generative AI. And you can see the rest of the text in here. So these are the major changes that you need to learn about. Now, there's some minor additions, and 2.5D, root guard, loop guard, BPDU filter, and BPDU guard. So some textbooks didn't include these, and you know, I'm not bragging or anything, but I actually did include these because I inferred from other syllabus topics, Cisco can be sneaky and you think it's not in there, but this is Cisco CCNA Simplified, and you can see I've added the enhancements to Cisco Spanning Tree Protocol, including the ones mentioned, and also in a couple of other books I'll come to later. So, which has been added, I'm pretty sure there were valid testing topics, as I said. So configure layer 2 security, DHCP, DHCP snooping. So this is why I think it was already in the syllabus and a valid testing topic. And I think there were questions on those topics, although I can't, I'm not allowed to say officially. So any other references to ports and LAN security, for example, port states, forward and blocking, again, you can infer. So they've reworded a few things. I think you can't read much into most of it. For example, 25B, port states, forwarding and blocking. 25B now says port states and roles. And again, it's italicized to show you the change. So I think it's obvious that what they want you to know for the port roles. Other changes, just different little words have changed. And I don't know whether they've had a proofreader check and said it needs to change or something else, but describe the need for private IPv4 addressing and then just describe private IPv4 addressing. It doesn't really make sense to me. On-premise and cloud has now changed to on-premises and cloud. I think that was just a typo. Describe the use of syslog features, including facilities and severity levels. It just says now and levels. Again, that doesn't make any difference to anything. So what's been removed? Cisco 1.1e, controllers and Cisco DNA Center and WLC, that's been removed. Now, I think they do refer to wireless LAN controllers later on in the syllabus. You can go up to the PDF compare and do the control F for find and see if WLC is still in there. Yeah, you can do that. I won't do it now. So just because something's been taken out, just be careful because they do refer to wireless networking still, wireless devices. So maybe you won't be expected to configure any wireless security using wireless LAN controller. DNA center's gone, as I said. So they're the major changes. It's nothing to worry about. It's pretty easy going. So testing dates, your last date to test is August 19th, 2024. After that, you won't be able to take the 1.0 version. The new version starts on the next day, the 20th. So just be careful when you book your exam. Having said that, you know, if you've studied for the old one and just added a little bit, I'm sure you'd be fine with the new version. It's no more than 10% of the syllabus. I put some FAQ here. What if I miss the exam cutoff date? It's too late. New study guides. As far as I know, everyone who's writing study guides is just adding some information to their errata pages. As I said, I already included this in my study guides. You can come to the blog post here or check on Amazon. Cisco CCNA Simplified has got a help page, a free resources page with loads of exams. So I'll add some information to that. 101 Lab Cisco CCNA has got all the new topics that you would be tested on in a lab. So that's already in there, so that doesn't need to change. And then Cisco CCNA 60 Days also has it on there as well. So that's it. Yeah, I've got nothing else to say. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. I've got loads of freebies and goodies, including the entire courses. And at the bottom of the blog post, there's a newsletter if you want to stay in touch. Again, I send out lots of information about the industry and certification. So thanks for listening. I'll see you on the next post.